Last summer, we ran a video contest for students in the region, and we asked the question, what are you going to do about climate change? And we have the winning team here from Father Michael Gates Catholic Secondary School. Their video is entitled Open Their Eyes, and it's created by Shania Zane, Davina, and Eliana, and it was the direction of their teacher, Jason Parishuk. And the winning video is really impactful. It shows the passion of our youth about climate change. It shows the importance of individual action. And I have to say personally, every time I watch the video, I get goosebumps. I hope you all enjoy it. So I'm going to turn it over to the students because they're going to have something to say.
Good morning, Madam Mayor and Council members. We'd like to thank the City of Mississauga for giving us the opportunity to not only showcase our skills in film production, but to also bring awareness and attention to the issue of climate change.
As future leaders and creators, it is our responsibility to be aware of the problems facing our world and work towards tackling them.
This platform that we have been given helps us connect with others who are also passionate about making a change.
We'd also like to thank the Council for inviting us and allowing us to be here today to witness experts in their respective fields. And here is our video.
Thank you. You don't have to speak to us.
Climate change is taking the world by storm, literally. Carbon dioxide, methane, and nitrous oxide, three of the deadliest gases on Earth, make up 97% of greenhouse gases. 15% of carbon emissions comes from deforestation. The drastic increase in the Earth's temperature for the first time in 166 years contributes to the rise in sea levels. The waste in landfills breaks down, removing oxygen and causing methane to be released into the atmosphere. To the reality of climate change. I will be more efficient in the ways I travel, like carpooling or biking. I will create this garbage by using reusable materials. I will try to lessen my usage of fossil fuels. I will help plant trees within my local community, but I can't do it without you. The future of this world is in our hands.
Started off as a final assignment for these young men and women, and the second component was to enter it into the contest. And after I saw the film, I had to concur with Julius that it gave me shivers. They got 100% on the project, and I had to proceed with money to put it on. It didn't take much coercing, though, I assure you. But I could tell the kids, the students were really getting into this project. They came to me one day during working on the project and said, Mr. Harris, can we come in with some paints and paint our hands?
That was so impressive.
Yeah, I didn't really know what to say. I said, okay, and saw Zane making photographs of the hands, and they said, don't worry about it, sir, it'll be good, don't worry about it. And rest assured, they kept telling me this, and I was quite impressed with what they did. So at the end of the day, they got 100%, and here we are.
Thank you very much,
councilors, Mayor, for having us in today.
Okay, Jason, just stay put. I think that some councilors would like to make some comments.
Okay.
Thank you. And to your councilor, who is responsible for the area, Councilor Unica.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Wonderful to have the kids here. Madam Mayor, I had the privilege of Councilor Kovac and Councilor Starr were with us as well as part of the catchment area of councilors. As you all know, I'm very proud of your school. The only one in the downtown core of the city. Father Gates always does remarkable things on so many fronts, and this was just another one. So I was invited as well on behalf of the city and the CBC to see the presentation. I just thought it was remarkable. And of course, as a result of your presentation, you won the award that you got, Mr. Stephen Zooks, to come forward and give a presentation. Councillor Kovacs and Councillor Starr and I saw a remarkable presentation about this gentleman, Sustainable Joe's, and how he lived off the grid for a year and told us just an amazing story. Marvelous man in his own right. Maybe I hope to have him here at some point. But just the amazing things that a group of students can do. My colleagues talks normally for this, a lot of people know, I look at the world from a lot of perspectives and all the problems that we have and all the problems we have. But if I ever want to be uplifted, I go to my high schools in my ward, yours, T.L. Kennedy, and meet with some of the young kids in projects like this, and you give us hope. And I think it's well placed. So with that, Madam Mayor, at the appropriate time, I've asked my staff through your office as well to create certificates for the four kids, and perhaps you and I could present them at the appropriate time. Thank you very much. You made your school and the ward very, very proud.
Very good. Thank you. Thank you. And Councillor Colbert.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Just wanted to thank big thank you to the students from Father Michael Hayes, a school neighboring Ward 4, and the councillor for your work in connecting with the group. Mr. Darischuk, who I know very well, a close family friend of mine, who's a very close friend of my older brother. So thank you, Mr. Darischuk, for being here, for being so supportive of your students, and to the students for bringing more awareness to environmental issues and sustainability. Thank you. Well done. Great work.
Great work. Okay, why don't we go over and present those certificates to the students?
Let's have the whole group. Yeah, let's have the whole group.
You don't need to open it.
I want the kids closest to the mayor.
Well, why don't we do two and two?
And maybe some along the
stairs. Counselors come up closer to
here. Someone on the stairs, come on around, and up on the stairs behind them, perhaps. Oh, okay, thank you.